Welcome again to another Curator's Chat here at Beringer Crawford Museum. I'm Jason French, Curator of Collections. Today I wanted to share a few Civil War artifacts with you, and these are actually pretty special because they're Confederate swords and Confederate sidearms. Swords were always a sidearm. They were rarely ever a primary weapon in history, even back in medieval times. But these are rare Confederate examples. The top one here is a beautiful example of a Confederate naval cutlass. Now, these were modeled after a U.S. naval cutlass made around, I think it was an Ames pattern, 1841, I believe. The Confederate Navy, of course, was making or having these manufactured by the Confederacy for their purposes during the Civil War. This one was likely never, ever used. It's a beautiful example of these swords, pretty rare sword. Beneath it is yet another sword length thing, a short sword, but it's actually a Confederate D-guard Bowie knife. Now, the Confederate Bowie knives with D-guards are pretty much a style of their own. And this one is a pretty rare example because it is quite long. It's got about a 21-inch blade, about 2 inches wide. It still has its maker's marks on it. I believe it's a WAH. I suspect, as many of these were, this was probably made in Georgia. This one has been excavated. Unlike the sword above it, that likely never saw any conflict, this one was probably lost on a battlefield. So it has kind of the wear, the use wear and marks on it. It's missing one of its handle scales, which is curly maple. I suspect it's because when it was on the ground, that scale was the scale facing the ground. And then as it kind of got covered up by debris over the years until it was found, it rotted away. But it's a beautiful example of a Confederate D-guard Bowie, and a long one, and just the same as this wonderful cutlass is a good example of a naval cutlass. And we think about, you know, both of these are kind of very much Confederate and Civil War bits of history. And with cutlasses, I often think about not only the deep water sailors and their masted sailing vessels and some of the early steamers, or the Monitor and the Merrimack, or the Virginia, as it was called at the time. I think about the guys that were manning boats that were made right here in Northern Kentucky or in Cincinnati, that were on the rivers, and they were part of the Navy, and they were defending either the Confederacy or the Union by fighting for the control of the inland rivers. Our area was a naval port. Cincinnati was a naval port during the Civil War. And a lot of the boats that were being made were turned into gunboats to fight along the rivers. And actually, both of these styles of swords could have been commonly seen on a naval vessel, especially a Confederate naval vessel, that would have just been an old steamboat on the river. You might have seen both of these on the river during the Civil War, but I don't believe that this one was ever used. This one definitely was lost on a battlefield, but I just wanted to share that with you. They're really part of our wonderful treasures here at Beringer Crawford Museum. I love talking about them and showing them. I hope you enjoy and you've learned something. If you like and subscribe, we appreciate it, and we'll see you in another video.